First and foremost, I want to give all praises to Yahweh, Baha Hashem, Yahweh Shah, Baha Hashem, Rakakadash. Second, I want to give double honors to the elders and apostles of GMS that do rule well. Peace, love, hope, and salutations to the hopeful elect that scattered across the four corners of the earth, where Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shah has you scattered it. Shalom unto you, Akim, that's out there risking your life and your freedom to preach this gospel and this good news. Okay? Via highways and byways or via the internet. Shalom. Shalom to you, confusion of face, Israelites that scattered abroad. You know, the Israelites that may look like the members of the other nations, but your bloodline goes back to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. You know, and if your spirit can receive it, you're an Israelite. So shalom to you. Shalom to you, sincere Agua out there. You women that do learn and subscribe. Shalom to you, few children. Okay? Today's lesson is really going to be based about,
the glow.
You know, that glow that you have that makes you really, stand out. Perfection. Trying to really achieve and chase perfection. But overall, don't let anybody take away from you something that's yours. And it's really based about faith, because when I was watching the movie Last Dragon last night, I had looked at all the different trials and tribulations that Bruce Leroy had went through just to receive perfection. And his sensei was telling him, you're the one. You have to believe that you're the one. You have to believe that you're going to be delivered. You have to believe that Yahweh Hashem HaShah is going to bless you with spiritual power. You have to believe overall that you're a part of the elect. Okay? So it's like, it's a big time spiritual, message that comes behind a lot of these movies, because back then we didn't know who we were. So of course Esau could just, put it in there. But right now, and this then, right now, in this day and age, Salakim, you gotta forgive me for the outside noise. If you hear anything outside, just typical Jay acting like fucking dumbasses and everything. But giving all praise, honor, and glory to Yahweh Bashem Yahushah. Yahweh is the name of the Heavenly Father, who the world ignorantly calls God, and Yahweh Shah is the name of the only begotten Son, who the world ignorantly calls Jesus Christ. Okay? And these days that's coming real soon, it's around the corner. You can want to call upon the names of your power. Call upon the names of Yahweh, Baha Shem, Yahweh Shah. So you call upon the names of Yahweh, Baha Shem, Yahweh Shah, and Baha Shem means in the name. Okay? So let me get this. This is Isaiah chapter 40, verse 29 on down. He give power to the faint, and to them that have no might, he increaseth strength. Okay? Even a youth shall fail and be weary, and the young men shall utterly fail, shall utterly fall. But they that wait upon Yahweh shall renew their strength, and they shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. Okay? Yahweh Hashem HaShah is going to give us spiritual power on another level that has not been seen, or eyes cannot compare to it. Things that your ears have not even, really indulged in a person's mind. Alright? And what really made me come across, I was watching it last night, and this stood out to me. This really stood out to me, everything that Bruce Leroy had to go through to get what he wanted, all right, that perfection, all right, don't let anybody take away, what it is that you're trying to achieve, especially in this ministry, all right, if you're trying to achieve perfection, you have to go through the different trials and tribulations, and it wasn't just given to Bruce Leroy, no, Bruce Leroy had to fight for it. He asked me, got his ass whooped, but at the end of it, he ended up, getting that glow. All right, and I'ma play it. Oh, as we can see, showing up, he has another type of energy, and that's that negative, you know, energy, that wicked energy. But the true, the true power was given to Bruce Lee because he had faith and he believed he was the one. You have to believe to kill the one as well. You have to believe to kill the one that you have behind your God. With this type of power, you know, and you just often have to believe that your family will love. Right? It can be told to you all day, but if you don't believe, that it's about believing. Right? And then Bruce Lee, ultimately, he believed, you know, and the outcome of him believing, you know, he got the glow, he got the power, you know, he got the woman, you know. This is 2 Samuel, verse 22. This is chapter 22, Salakim. Verse 30. For by thee I have run through a troop, by my power have I leaped over a wall, okay? So spiritual power was given to King David, all right, to do miraculous things because King David believed, all right? King David had faith that he was going to be able to do these things, and by the grace and the mercy of Yahweh Bashem HaWashah, it was given to him, all right? How many people you know that can leap over a wall, all right? I'm not talking about no little wall, you know, that you might build around your house. I'm talking about a huge wall that might hide a village or a castle or whatever. You know, it could have been a 100-foot wall, a 50-foot wall, all right? But King David had that belief, and he believed that he was the one, you know, and ultimately that power was given to him, okay? So we got to have that same mentality, that we're the one. Because Yahweh Bashem HaWashah called us into this thing to change us, all right? So we could seek perfection, okay? Because by faith, you can do a lot of things, all right? And I'm going to end it off with this, okay? Okay? This is Luke chapter 17, verse 6. And this is Yahweh Shah speaking. And Yahweh Shah said, if ye have faith as a grain of a mustard seed, you might say unto this sycamine tree, Be thou plucked up by the root, and be thou planted in the sea, and it shall obey you, okay? Power like that is coming, but you just have to, you have to have faith. First and foremost, you gotta have your faith that you're the one, alright? You have to really question yourself, because that really stuck on me when I was, like I said, I was watching The Last Dragon, and go just say it a little bit more in depth detail, you know, when he was given the glow. But you know, his sensei early, if you know, you have to watch the movie, you know, for all the arguments, especially my younger subscribers. If you have not seen the movie The Last Dragon, I would highly tell you to check it out, because it has a deep spiritual meaning. You know, and this was an Israelite. That's what makes it really stands out anymore. You know, really, really more than anything. Because, you know, Bruce Lee was an Israelite. Okay, but he was chasing for perfection. It was crazy. Bruce Lee was different from a lot of different Jakes. Yeah, he was ridiculed and made fun of and had to go through his different trials and tribulations. But at the end of the day, he believed and he achieved that perfection. All right? He achieved the goal that he was ultimately looking for. And that was to perfect, you know, to take yourself to another level, to achieve perfection. And that's what we hear, you know, us brothers that, you know, that preach the truth. You know, us brothers that's making this a daily sacrifice, we're achieving that perfection because we ultimately want that crown of life. Okay? We want to know how it is to really live, okay? And we're not living on this side. But we have faith in Yahweh Bashem Al-Shad. He's going to renew all things. And he's going to give us the things we're going to need. Because Jacob's trouble is right around the corner. And we're going to have our faith. It's going to have to be on extreme level. All right? Because our faith is going to get tested and tried a lot. But you have to know that the Lord is going to be with us. Do everything. All right? Yeah, we might have to take, you know, our bumps and bruises here and there. But ultimately, I mean, who doesn't take an ass whooping sometimes to achieve perfection? All right? So you just ultimately have to really think within yourself, you know, with your faith. Because it said if you have faith the size of the grain of a mustard seed, you know, the smallest amount of faith, you know, you might say unto this sycamine tree, be thou plucked up by the root, okay? And it'll obey you. So furthermore, what you think is going to be given to someone that has 100% faith, that's putting all that faith, you know, that time, that effort, and that faith is on an extreme level for Yahweh Bashem El-Shah. They're going to be given so much more. All right? You got to really sit down. You got to think about that. Okay? So I hope this video was edifying. I brought this out. Lord willing. You know, giving all praise, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shah, Bahashem, Rakakadash. That warns to the elders and apostles of GMS to do rule well. Peace, love, hope, and salutations to the hopeful elect that scattered across the four corners of the earth where Yahweh Bashem Yahshua has placed you at. Alright? Just know that we're all seeking perfection. Alright? We're us brothers, as diligent part of this, we're seeking perfection. We're seeking to be perfected in this thing. But we also have to, you also have to have that faith and know that you're the one. Alright? Are you a part of the elect? You know, you got to have that faith. Okay, because it goes a long way, and you just have to have that faith in knowing that you are the one. Okay, especially if you're a part of this truth, because it goes along a long way. Trust me. Okay. So, like I said, I hope this video was edifying. Any of you brothers, Akim out there, maybe Agua has never seen the movie Last Dragon. I would recommend you to go see it. You know, it's an 80s movie. The old school movie, you feel me? But it still got the message, is still there, okay? The message is still there, man. So, like I said, man, giving all praises, honor, and glory to Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shah, Bahashem Rakakadash, man. You know, Akim out there, you feel me, man? Love you, brothers, man. Keep chasing perfection, man. And your brothers just each and every day, you know, have that faith and, you know, have that faith to know that you're the one. Okay, have that faith to know that, you know, that you're going to receive that glow, all right? Because you have it now, but it's going to be put out there on a mainstream level, you know, on a higher stream level, you know, like never before, you feel me? So we just got to each and every day, you know, count our blessings and just keep our faith, okay? Because the Lord is going to look out for us, you know? And this is not something that every brother is going to receive. No, just the ones that have the faith and believe that they're the one. You know, the one that was chosen to receive the things that Yahweh Bashem Yahushua said. Because ultimately, all Israel is going to be saved. But you have some of them. You have a clamor of brothers that's just going to be given. You know, their faith is just on I lost my track of thought. That faith is just on another type of level. You feel me? So, man, you know, just keep, you know, like I said, man, you brothers, man, stay strong. Love you, brothers, man. Shalom.